If you've heard anything before about this car, the 2017 Infiniti QX30, it probably has to do with its corporate parents, an odd couple if there ever was one. Renault-Nissan, Infiniti's corporate overlords, inked a deal with Mercedes-Benz to share some mechanical components and platforms. That deal put a new, very modern 2.0-liter turbocharged inline 4 under the hood of the Q50 and was the genesis of what you're looking at here. What are you looking at here? We drove this car in 2015, when it was called a Q30. Originally it was going to be the lower riding counterpart to the slightly jacked up QX30. Then Infiniti decided it'd make more sense to sell all variants of this vehicle as Qs in the US, so we have three slightly different flavors of the QX30 instead. There's the normal version, the Sport, which is 0.6 inches lower, and the AWD, which is 1.2 inches higher. Infiniti brought us to Seattle to sample the Sport and AWD flavors on a semi-circumnavigation of the Puget Sound. It didn't rain a drop, thanks for asking, and instead was sunny and mild the whole time. It's easy to make the QX30 sound more confusing than it actually is. This is essentially a Mercedes-Benz GLA 250 with full exterior styling and partial interior design by Infiniti, built in the UK alongside several other Nissans. The powertrain and chassis, including the optional AWD system, were all co-developed with partner Daimler, with final calibration and tuning by Infiniti engineers. Here's another way of explaining it. Infiniti needs an entry-level car to appeal to new premium car shoppers, and the QX30 is the prescription. It's a hatchback that's been given the mildest of QV treatments and a lot of marketing descriptors. That's because hatchbacks are sales death in America. In Europe, they'll see right through the QV posturing and realize it's just a hatchback offered in three different suspension heights. Whatever you call it to make it palatable to Americans, it's a useful little vehicle. This car is mechanically identical to the Q30, so there are some things we can gloss over. Both are powered by a transverse-mounted 2.0-liter Mercedes inline 4. It's a turbocharged, direct-injection gasoline engine, and it sure feels like one. It sounds like a rock tumbler full of nickels and runs out of breath at about 5,000 revolutions per minute. All versions make 208 horsepower at 5,500 revolutions per minute and 258 pounds to foot of torque between 1,200 and 4,400 revolutions per minute, more than adequate but less than thrilling. The engine sends power along through a dim-witted 7-speed dual-clutch gearbox, which occasionally got crossed up in sport mode and is a snooze in eco. Even though Infiniti did the throttle and transmission calibration, it's a very German driving experience.